22 after 9. Thanks for being with us on Live at 9. You carry them everywhere. Of course, we're talking about your smartphone, tablet. In the name of making life easier, Live at 9's new segment, there's an app for that.
And today, it's all about getting the benefit of a workout and saving you some cash as well. So how does having a personal trainer right at your fingertips sound to you? Digital strategist Sherri Motes joins us with all of the details this morning. Good to have you here.
Thank you. It's great.
So we hear about the popularity these days, of course, of our tablets, of our smartphones, and now there's an app for getting us, or apps for getting us in shape. Sherri, right. What about it? How well are some of these apps working these days?
Well, it's interesting because you do need to test the apps. And so that's one of the things that I do, and I find the ones that work very well.
Yeah.
And I found one that works very well for women who want to get fit very quickly. Now, it's going to take time, obviously, but consistency, 7 minutes a day.
Oh, any of us have that.
Yes. You can even get the bikini body you've been wanting.
Really?
Yes.
No, that says a lot there.
Of course, I needed to start 6 months ago, but.
So you actually tried one of these, what, last night?
That's right.
You
absolutely.
Are. So how well did it work? What were the results like? How were you feeling?
What sets this one aside? Or
well, one of the things that I love about it when I look at it is it has a place for beginners. Okay. It also has high intensity.
Okay.
It has it breaks it down by what you want. So, for instance, if you want sexy arms,
gotcha.
Then you can click on that. And most of them are going to be anywhere from 7 to 20 minutes. And so, in fact, most of them, about 80% of them, are around 7 or 8 minutes long.
How do you, because the advantage, of course, with a personal trainer is that there's a voice there making you, you can do one more, push through the burn,
right.
Hold the whatever, you know, you can tell I don't work out enough. So
right, hold,
know lingo,
you know, your
right.
own, what do they call
so,
it when you,
yeah,
you're holding your own intensity.
Through the burn, right.
Yes.
So, because we all want to give up. Does this right. one help you push through that and stay with it as a trainer would?
Well, the thing I found that was very motivating to me was the fact that it was only 7 minutes long.
Okay.
Oh my goodness, I know I can do this. It's only 7 minutes. And then it says, do you want to go to the next? And you think, well, it's only 7 minutes longer.
Oh,
why not?
Okay.
So then you can push the button and go on. And it times you for each one. So you know, oh, I've only got 30 seconds more that I have to do this particular move. One of the moves I loved with sexy arms was the prayer pulse and using your own resistance. That's the word I was looking for.
Right, right.
You do the prayer pulse.
For 7 minutes.
Well, no, this was one of the moves. So they have you moving in different ways. Obviously, you have this one where you're using your own resistance and you're pushing the bar up, right?
Yeah.
And
okay.
so it takes you through those areas.
And talks you through it.
And it does not talk. No, there's no automation on this particular app. It's called Workout for Women. Mm-hmm. It strictly has the person showing you. It's an animated person that's showing you the moves, and it's timing you.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
My question, though, should we be concerned? Because on some apps, I mean, whether it's a fitness tracker or an app, sometimes they give you the results that you think you want, like maybe you have walked 3 or 4 miles, but you've actually really walked maybe one.
Mm-hmm.
Should we be a little bit leery? How do we know it's really giving us the true results, though?
Well, I believe that we know if we're telling ourselves the truth. So, for instance, if we've done what this app has told us to do for 7 minutes,
right. mm-hmm.
then we've burned 78 calories, which is what it told me last night. But I know I took a little break to go stir the food in the kitchen.
Okay.
So I know I didn't quite burn that many calories.
Gotcha. Right. Well, there is always going to be personal accountability, but
absolutely.
If you're somewhat self-motivated, this might be something you can add to your current workout plan.
Yes.
Or do this if you're homebound, for instance.
Exactly.
You have kids,
if you have kids, you don't want to take the kids, or you want to save time, because when you go to the gym, you have to.
And are these are some apps most of us should be able to use? I mean, no matter what age
simple?
Or what weight size or
Very.
Whatever or gender.
Yes. Oh, absolutely. There's beginners. There's also advanced. That's what I like about it. So it doesn't matter what level you're on, you can start.
But what about technologically? Easy to use for those who are not from a personal fitness standpoint, but technically?
Yes.
Easy?
Now,
download
I know being a digital strategist that it's easy for me to say yes, but it took me 2 minutes to set up the app, if that.
Okay.
And it also syncs with your health app on your phone.
Oh, that's cool.
Which is excellent.
To track your results.
Good information there.
Yes.
Okay, I like it.
Glad to see you.
Great to see
Good information,
Seven
as
minutes.
Always.
I can do that.
All right.